We've shown you how we migrate online workloads using a packed compiler to guarantee results, but what about batch? Some people recommend rewriting the JCL as shell scripts or another language and hope they get it right. We don't believe in guesswork at Heirloom, so we provide a fully JCL compatible batch execution engine instead. It's called Elastic Batch Platform, or EBP, and it's cloud-ready, REST-enabled, compatible with major schedulers if you don't wish to use ours, and runs under any Java container. Today we're using Tomcat. In this video, we'll use JCL to create a file, and then read the file back using another batch job step, all in 60 seconds. Let's start the clock. Here's our EBP operators console in a browser. We'll define a job class and an initiator for that class. Here's our Eclipse-based IDE with the EBP server interface already loaded. This is the JCL we'll use. You can see standard IDCAMS instructions in here and then a step to call a program. That program is here. We'll need to compile and deploy it so EBP can use it. Let's do that now and save it in the systemlib folder that's already defined in EBP's configuration. Now we'll submit the JCL to EBP. I'm doing this through our Eclipse plugin, but of course EBP could get this via a scheduler or a REST web service call. We'll watch it run in the system's operator console. EBP will analyze the JCL, then using its JES engine, it will call IDCAMS to take sequential data into JCL and create and load an indexed file. The second step told it to call our list table program, originally in COBOL, but now obviously in Java to produce our output. We'll jump back to Eclipse and look at that output. Here it is, the JCL parse results and our program's output, as you can see here. And there you go. In 60 seconds, we migrated a COBOL batch application to Java and executed JCL to define a file and then call that program. All this with zero changes to the original code, ensuring 100% identical batch execution to your mainframe, but now on open, scalable systems.